Yes, good afternoon everyone. Welcome back to your biology theory class. And today I was discussing the chapter human reproduction, right? So have we completed this chapter, discussion of this chapter? Question we have completed, please tell me. Up to the true false, right? I think up to the true false we have completed. Okay, so open your book, let me discuss about the other question from this chapter. So we have completed up to the question number 16. Today I will discuss from the question number 17. So what is the question number 17? What is menstrual cycle? With that, which hormones regulate menstrual cycle? What is menstrual cycle? And with that, another question is there, which hormone regulate menstrual cycle? So if we open the diagram, that a diagrammatic presentation of various events of menstrual cycle is there. So first, what is menstrual cycle? The reproductive cycle in the female primates. That means, what are the examples of primates? So first we know that we can differentiate like primates and non-primates. So who will come under the primates? Monkeys, apes and human beings. And those who are having four legs, they will come actually that non-primates. So the reproductive cycle in the female primates is called menstrual cycle. Okay, and with that you have to write that menstrual cycle starts at the puberty, which is called as menarche, and it ends near about at the age of 40 to 45 years, which is called as menopause. And the menstrual cycle is repeated at an average of 28 to 29 days. And this cycle of events starting from the menstrual cycle. Okay, so you have to write down all this small information in the question, what is menstrual cycle. So next question, with that there is another question, which hormones regulate menstrual cycle? Can you tell me which hormones are playing main role in regulation of the menstrual cycle? I know you know the answer. Tell me the name of the hormones which are playing role in regulation of the menstrual cycle. Estrogen, okay. Progesterone, okay. Estrogen, progesterone, and follicle stimulating hormone. Very good. And check the spelling of luteinizing hormone. Okay, so these are the main hormones, estrogen, progesterone, follicle stimulating hormone, LH. Okay, so the LH and FSH are considered as gonadotropins, right? So these are the hormones which are playing role in maintaining the menstrual cycle. Very good. Now come to the question number 18. What is parturition? What is parturition? And with that, another question is that which hormones are involved in induction of parturition? So first you have to write down what is parturition. So what you will write, that the average duration of human pregnancy is about 9 months, which is called as gestation period. Vigorous contraction of the uterus at the end of the pregnancy causes expulsion or delivery of the fetus. This process of delivery of the fetus or childbirth is called as parturition. We know that the process of delivering baby is the called as parturition. So this is the answer of what is parturition. And the second question is that which hormones are involved in induction of parturition? Can you tell me the answer? Which hormones are playing role in that parturition? Because parturition is induced by complex neuroendocrine mechanism. A signal will be sent from the fully developed fetus and the placenta, which will induce the mild uterine contraction, which is called as fetal ejection reflex, and that will trigger the release of a hormone which is called as oxytocin. Very good. So this oxytocin hormone will be released from maternal pituitary. As you know that pituitary, from already you have read about the pituitary gland in the class 11, that pituitary gland is having two lobes, anterior pituitary, posterior pituitary. So the from the posterior pituitary oxytocin hormones can be released. Okay. And oxytocin will help in the contraction and relaxation of the uterine, smooth muscle of the uterus. And the another hormone which is playing role, that is relaxin. Very good. So these two hormones are playing main role in the parturition process. Now come to the next question, question number 19. In our society, the women are often blamed for giving birth to daughters. Can you explain why this is not correct? Let me repeat this question. In our society, the women are often blamed for giving birth to daughters. Can you explain why this is not correct? So what was the question? That in our society we have seen for giving the birth of a girl child or daughter, women are blamed. Because as you can remember that women are having no role in determining the sex of the child. Okay, as women are homogametic, they will produce X and X, but males are heterogametic, that's why male will produce X and Y, right? So when X from the mother will fuse with the X from the father, then what will get? XX, the child will be girl. And when the X of the mother will fuse with the Y of the father, then the child will be boy, that means XY. So as in case of mother, they are having both the X's, that is why they can't help in the determination of the sex of the child. Okay. So we have to write it down that as human female is XX, as male is XY. At the time of gamete production, the female will from the female 2X will be produced, and in case of males it will be either X or Y. So the 50% of the sperms will carry X chromosome, while other 50% will carry the Y chromosome. And after the fusion of male and female gametes, the zygote would carry either XX or XY, depending on whether the sperm carrying X or Y fertilize the ovum. Okay, so it is totally dependent on the sperm, not on the ovum. And the zygote carrying XX would develop into a female baby and XY would form a male baby. So from this we can say that female are having no role in determination of the sex of the child. So it is totally wrong if we blamed for giving a birth child to a woman. Okay. So this is the answer for this particular question. Now come to the next one. How many eggs are released by a human ovary in a month? How many eggs do you think would have been released if a mother gave birth to identical twins? Would your answer change if the twins born were fraternal? So, what is the answer of first question? How many eggs are released by a human ovary in a month? Your answer is 1. Very good. Now tell me the answer of second question. How many eggs do you think would have been released if the mother gave birth to identical twins? what will be the answer? The answer again will be 1. Very good. Third question is that would your answer change if the twins were born were fraternal? So the answer for the previous one was that identical twins. What will happen if the twins are fraternal? Then what will be the number? Answer will be the same or the different? It will be 1 or 2? Can you tell me the answer? Very good. So the answer will be 2 or more. Very good. So the answer will be different, as we know that in the case of identical twin, as single ovum or egg will be fused with the single sperm and zygote will be formed, but at the time of division the zygote will be splitted into two and then two twins will be formed. These are considered as identical twins, okay? But in case of fraternal twins, more than one eggs can be fused with different sperms and two different twins can be produced. They will not be exactly alike with each other. That is why they are considered as fraternal twins. Okay. Now come to the last question from this chapter. How many eggs do you think were released by the ovary of a female dog which gave birth to 6 puppies? What will be the answer? Let me repeat the question. How many eggs do you think were released by the ovary of a female dog which gave birth to 6 puppies? Why 6? Because why? Can you explain it? Your answer is right. So okay, nothing to no issues, leave it. So that they didn't ask about that part, so they just asked the number. So the answer is right. So with that we have completed the total exercise from the chapter human reproduction, and in my next class I will discuss about the course exercise about the chapter reproductive health. Okay, in the next class we will discuss about the chapter reproductive health. So I will suggest you that please read this chapter very carefully, else you will not be able to answer all the questions from the exercise. No need of solving the exercise at your home. Please read the chapters thoroughly so that you can answer in my next class. Okay. Payal, I think yes. But I can't remember about have you written it correctly or not, because I have checked already few days ago. Okay. But if any corrections required, I will tell you. Okay, if any corrections are required, I will tell you. Okay. So for today that's it. Thank you and bye bye for today.